Hello class, my name is Cameron Sparavon and I will be talking about balancing chemical equations. First off, what is a balanced equation in chemistry? A balanced equation is a reaction in which the number of atoms on the reactant side is equal to the number of atoms on the product side. Here is an example of a chemical equation, however, it is not balanced. As you can see, there are two oxygen atoms on the reactant side and only one on the product side. How can we fix this? To balance this equation, I added the number 2 in front of the water, so the oxygen on both sides is now equal to 2. What did this do to our hydrogen? Since we added a 2 to our H2, there are now 4 hydrogen atoms on our product side. Let's add a 2 to our reactant side's hydrogen and see what happens. Now here we have a balanced equation, but let's double check just to be sure. We have 4 hydrogen atoms on both sides and we have 2 oxygen atoms on both sides. This means we have a balanced equation. Let's try a harder one. We'll do Fe2O3 plus C to make Fe plus CO2. We start by drawing a line down the center and then write out which atoms are on which sides. To make it easier to read, I put the same elements in the same line. Now count up how many of each atom there is and write the number next to it. This is to keep track of our numbers so we can ensure a balanced equation. From here, go through and balance everything out. Start with odd numbers first and make them even. Since I added a 2 in front of the FeO3, I write in how many I have next to the previous numbers. There are 4 irons and 6 oxygens, so I go to the other side to make it equal. Lastly, we have 3 carbon atoms on the product side, so we need 3 on the reactant side. Make sure all the numbers match up and it's balanced. Let's try one last problem. Let's do C3H8 plus O2 to make H2O plus CO2. Again, start by drawing your line down the middle and write out what you have on each side. Remember to keep each element in its same line. From here, go in and start balancing. I need 8 hydrogens on the product side, so I did this first. Next, I put a 3 in front of the carbon on the product side, so it equals the amount on the reactant side. Finally, go through and balance out the oxygens, so there are 10 on each side. Make sure everything is equal and we have a balanced equation. Thank you for watching!